slowing down a little bit on making the calls. I have not been doing the five offers a day. I got caught up in some other things, but I do have some help. Got Peter helping me, Peter Soros and Derek. But I'll tell you, 2 weeks ago, I used the guts and I brought in two new students on payments. So I'm seeing a lot of payments right now for community members and students. I think Chris and I, we were talking about that a couple of weeks ago. I'm starting to see a little shift in this economy where people are more or less wanting to do payments on things. But we're just kind of ramping up the value for them. So they keep making those payments and we're just keeping our support really sticky and just providing so much.
You know, it's really funny. Do you ever have the situation, Brent, where you had a lead or a phone call and it was later in the day, you were tired, you had other things to do and whatever, and you said, well, maybe I should hold off making that call. And you said, okay, I'm just going to make that call.
Yep.
And that YOLO. call turned into be a money call.
Almost 50% of the time.
Doesn't that, pardon my language, ladies, doesn't that scare the shit out of you when you almost did not make that call? And that call, you know, they can always go to their your competition or somebody else. But, you make that call and it becomes a sale and you think to yourself, what if I didn't make that call?
That could have been one call. What if I did that more often? What if I just did that more often? And I think it's also because you're like, no F's given. You're like, I'm just going to use the guts. This guy's not going to waste my time. I'm not going to give any free education. Like, I'm here to offer you my program to change your life or call someone else, my brother. And like, that's when I make those sales. It's almost when I just don't care.
Is that showing that confidence, that ego there? What do you think's going through? It's a delicate thing, isn't it? Because